Ah, yeah, I'm making a video. It's be heading out, so we'll be going out soon. But I figure we'll start here and then we'll expand on the subject. So.
Could be so easily misunderstood. As I say, the big misunderstanding here is, or the big disagreement here is, whether or not Chiron was just explaining himself or trying to get everybody else or other people to join his bandwagon.
I don't know. I mean, realistically, right? You make videos, right? These people wrote books. They're basically compounding, explaining a theory of reality, of existence. They're pointing out these are certain facts. This is the only way I can put them together. This is their theory. They're not doing self-help books. I mean, generally speaking, except for maybe Nietzsche, who was just basically saying, "Oh, look, I did all the thinking part. The thinking part is, oh, we're fucking bugs. Never mind that, because that's no fun. So here's how to play a good game. Just be an egomaniacal motherfucker, and everything'd be fine." Something like that. Me, 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 me. Bullshit. Just forget about being part of the world, because you can't fix anything, because as soon as you touch anything, it goes all bad. It's just a cop out. Just, yeah. Start the war without me, I'm running that. I'm going home. Start everything without me. I'm going home. Selfish cunt. That's all you're advocating, buddy. Just quit pretending you're just doing some. I'm just opining on how I masturbate. Well, I mean, you got a girl pregnant how you masturbate, so you apparently don't know how to masturbate, right? I can explain to people. Look, if you want to, I can explain to you how you can have sex without making babies. Huh. Interesting.
That takes a lot more work than simply reading what he has to say. You have to know something about the man. You have to know something about how he developed. You have to know something
Oh,
about.
whatever, bullshit. Look, the fact that these guys can't tell and say anything explicitly because they don't understand the basic function. So again, this is where it all goes wrong, just like it goes wrong in physics, which I'm gonna have to get back to because that Mick, whatever his name is, cuckoo guy, he's fucking insane, and he's representing physics. And these idiots were insane, and they were representing philosophy. They're not doing philosophy. They're doing some kind of psychobabble, which you are doing, and which you'll demonstrate here. You'll basically admit it.
What his views on, were on other things to cross-reference them and read that into what he has to say.
Well, if you do that, then all these guys get disqualified because they apparently couldn't figure out that women are more than just fucking furry pussy.
Or what he would have assumed that his audience already thought of certain things. There's a temptation in philosophy, especially, to sort of get overly clinical and say that we can.
There, okay. Overly clinical. Is there any such thing as overly clinical in philosophy? Now, isn't that right there kind of a lie, a canard? Let's set up a false premise that there's such a thing as being too clinical, too explicit, too accurate, too complete in your argument. No, there's no such thing. There's only what you don't want to hear. That's boring. Evolution, that's boring. Where's the hookers? Evolution doesn't make hookers. Well, maybe it does.
Just nail things down easily with ideas like identity and non-contradiction, simplify things and make sense out of it all.
No, make have simple rules. That's right. Yeah, this is not really a difficult rule, is it? Is this is really something? I mean, I know it's stupid. I had to come on the internet to explain that suffering sucks, but to have to explain the contradiction, contradicting yourself is goddamn stupid. It's something stupid people do. Yes, if you're going to be logical and sensible and reasonable, you can't contradict your own fucking statements. You have to say your statements correctly. If you mean it's only partially something you. Our language isn't this broken. See, this guy wants to imply that we don't have the words, that we can't say anything, because we have some vocabulary that's nonsense. Well, you don't have to use that vocabulary. No one forces you to put love in print. No one forces you to use words like spontaneous or random or any other fucking word that doesn't have a real good definition. No one obliges you to do that, okay? We fall into this habit. And yes, we can fix the habit. Instead of saying me, I can say my brain in, when appropriate. Okay, there's certain circumstances where it's probably appropriate to say, a program running in my brain has compelled me to point out that blah, 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 blah. We can do this if we have to. And there's something necessary in doing it, because obviously without doing it, everything gets all fucked up and nobody can talk sense anymore. And all of a sudden there's UFOs and reptilians running the country. And, you know, there's all kinds of conspiracies and gods and demons and hobgoblins all out to get us. Bullshits.
And in my opinion, when you do that, you get things like morbid antinatalism and ephelism.
There's nothing morbid about it. It's just a fucking sad, pitiful recognition that what we are is flatworms. You're still a fish, primarily, right? Without the gills, you're just a goddamn fish swimming on land now. But, I mean, essentially, it's the same fucking bug. You're the same thing you were fucking 500 million years ago.
Because you've stripped everything of all of its meaning.
There we go. Stripped everything of all of its meaning. So what is all of this meaning you're saying exists? What is the fact? The clinical fact is that evolution has created a psychology. We can see it. We get hungry. We get horny. Wow. Then we have this social psychology that creates this ego mechanism, that creates this alpha bullshit, which creates this need to compete and this need to succeed, this need to be something by relative comparison, to feel good about ourselves. This is evolution, has created this stupid psychology that needs feeding, that needs entertaining. It's a fact. Okay? It's not a good fact. It's kind of pitiful that that's the primary mechanism of motivation in human society and culture, is we're still just feeding like stupid fish. We're still just following a trail of fucking goddamn whatever, fish pellets, fish chow.
But a series of ruthlessly...
I need to swim upstream, I need to swim upstream, I need to... I'm not going to ask why, I'm just going to do it, because nature says so. I have an impulse, I have an impulse, I have an impulse, I have an impulse. Who cares? This is not... to sit there and call that morbid, because you merely recognize that that's the simple mechanism. That's morbid? Morbid, how is it morbid to recognize... Hey, you know what? It's just a kind of a sick, stupid psychology. It's just a fucking addiction. And that maybe you shouldn't impose that. That maybe you're not competent to be a creator of life. Maybe you haven't passed a test. Maybe you don't know what the fuck you're doing. Maybe you have no control over the experiment. Gee, that's being morbid. It's being morbid to point out the fact.
Ugh. Applied formulae. And you're left with a worldview that is completely empty of any meaning.
Any meaning at all. Again, what meaning is existence supposed to have? That's right, you're supposed to have a delusion, a God delusion. So Nietzsche replaced the God delusion with the me delusion, the ego delusion, the be the mega man delusion, the alpha delusion, whatever you want to call it, the exceptionalism delusion. And so by that standard, right, the thing to do is learn how to sing and dance, because then you'll be exceptional. Being an exceptionally good, say, biologist and attempting to cure cancer, well, no, you're not going to get too many ego points for that. But yes, singing and dancing, sure. You'll go far.
A useless pack of science that isn't doing or going.
Useless pack of science, there you go. Isn't doing or going, right? He can't rub his dick on it, is all he's saying. It's not a good fuck. I tried to fuck it, and I didn't get off, and it was too rough, and I didn't enjoy it, so nah, I'm not going to do that anymore. Thinking about reality, yeah, it's not a good fantasy. That's all he's saying.
Anywhere, but it's left the actual meaning behind everything, behind it, almost.
Yeah, the actual meaning. So again, you're making an accusation, aren't you? So instead of talking about what you actually believe for your actual personal self, you are proselytizing a theory. You're saying there's an actual meaning that science isn't seeing. You're saying there's an actual meaning that some clinical morbid antinatalist isn't seeing. Yet you can't describe it rationally, and you admit you can't. You say that's why we all have to talk in aphorisms and poetry and palabras and bullshit. Is because you can't put it into rational language. That's right, because it's not rational. It's a bunch of gobbledygook that has to do with your own psychological problems, your own psychological conditioning.
Deliberately. deliberately stripped itself of meaning.
Deliberately stripped itself of meaning. Again, what? What does meaning mean? Oh, that's right. The new word for meaning is made up fantasy adventurism. Okay, and meaning isn't like you analyze the game and figure out how the dominoes tip. That's not meaningful. It's not meaningful to find out the truth or to talk about the truth. It's only meaningful to talk about some fantasy adventurism and how you're going to find your singularity or your golden unicorn or your bliss or whatever the fuck you think has real value when it doesn't actually have any value except psychological value to you. Your addiction, your heroin.
Now, okay, I can understand that. I can see that, you know, the way some people's minds work, that's just how they're going to approach anything.
Rational people. Yeah, there's rational people and irrational people, and then doubly irrational people.
I want contradictions or paradoxes or nuance in there or anything. You just want people to nail.
Yeah, that's right. I'm just so fucking goddamn sick of goddamn bullshit. This planet is just covered with a bunch of assholes talking out of their ass. Period. Lie after lie after canard after lie after fucking goddamn lie. You're all a bunch of fucking liars. And that's it. There's nothing else to say. You can't put four sentences together without there being a lie word in there somewhere.
At some sort of conclusion based on that. Language doesn't work that way.
It's supposed to. Yeah. So anyway, he goes on to talk about how, Pyrrho's got it right, and blah, 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 blah. Just a bunch of crap. Everybody's supposed to talk in poems and bullshit and nonsense and in henny-penny nonsense. We're not ever supposed to say anything explicit because somehow reality is too complex for an explicit conversation. And somehow the language doesn't do that. And the language, of course, can do that. We're just not doing it. Right? I mean, it's not like we have too few words. We have too many words. That's more the problem. And too many of the words are bullshit. They're not real words. They're lies. Yeah. Okay, so continuing. Really is a lovely day. Except I'm having nerves, which, you know, is the usual state for me. Anyway, it's not the usual state, but it's commonly my condition of discomfort. I started cleaning up and it's like, oh fuck, this is going to take centuries. Anyway, so unlike the previous couple of videos, you know, they're kind of generally on the subject of, reality really isn't that complicated. And if we're honest and dissect what's going on, piece by piece, just look at it honestly. Honestly evaluate what we're doing, what we're thinking, what we're feeling, how we're expressing that. And, we can have a conversation about what's going on. But, if we're going to have false premises, establish the existence of, just the creation of fake dimensions, or spirituality, or, some sort of religion gene, or, all this other kind of mush talk, that we have some basic nature that is completely uncorrectable by knowledge, or not correctable would be the wrong word, that can't be caged by information, can't be more productively expressed in our function and how we interact with the world. And we can do that. Our psychology can be understood. We can understand that, yes, I need to eat, I need to breathe, and then I need to compete. I need gratifications of ego. I need to feel sufficient, adequate, constructive, productive? And do we do that by lying about the truth, pretending, saying that the world wants me to stink and therefore I don't have to take a bath, or the world in reality, it's really, you just figure something that you're tied to ego-wise. We'll just say there, I've won that competition and now I don't have to compete anymore. I could argue, I still have hair. So there, I win. That's all I have to do is have hair, I win, you all lose, na 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 na. I'm exceptional now, and that's it. I don't have to go any further. And no, we can logically know that's meaningless crap. And that the real game is a bigger game. And again, this is where all these philosophers fail, because they were individual psychologies and they were talking out of their own psychology. They weren't having a conversation about reality. They were having a conversation about their interpretation of reality, their reaction to reality, how it made them feel, something like that. And that's certainly part of the conversation. But the biggest part of the conversation is the part where you climb out of your psychology. You go up the side of the maze. You go outside of yourself and your own agenda. And you start to look at it. And you say, what is it doing? What are the players doing? What is my... Take yourself out of your body. Take yourself out of the world even. Extract yourself. Pull yourself out and then look at it and say, what is it without me in it? What is it without my desire, my motivations, my attachments, my addictions? And then you'll come up with something more rational, something closer to your perspective when you see the other rats running the maze and you so easily discount their existence. And then you might realize, why is it that it's important when I'm doing it, and why is it unimportant when somebody else is doing it? And you might realize that, that's because me, my psychology has made me incapable of recognizing the difference. You see this rock and this rock, you're saying this is me and this is them, and somehow this them thing is somehow fundamentally different. So when you're it, right, it means something. When somebody else is it, it means nothing. And that's what you call a contradiction. You say, well, why is that? That's a hypocrisy. There's something wrong with that math. So that's where the math comes in. You figure out, I know philosophically this equals that. I know it as a fact, okay? There's no rational way I can make this into something different than that in any kind of rational way. And yet, my brain doesn't seem to apply that definition. And why is it not doing that? Oh, that's right, because I have a psychology. And the psychology is distorting the vision. It's breaking the glasses. Really quite lovely. Look at that little group. Too bad I don't have the better camera. Yes, sir. Quite lovely. Just a little patch of it, you know? It's kind of funny. Anyway, it's being exceptional. Anyway. So we're back to the same argument I've made over and over and over again, is that are people going to be required to talk philosophy, or are they just going to talk about masturbating, their psychology? How do you jerk your brain off? And it seems like all these people want to do is talk about how they jerk their brain off, how they have their little fantasy, know, cheese eating adventures. Oh, and isn't it wonderful? And you know, this is something that the listener should aspire to or feel totally connected to. It's just, you know, I certainly, that's where people live. All right, that's where most people live. I mean, most people are stupid, dim, dull, philosophically immature for certain, and psychologically immature. They aren't capable of doing a little tiny bit of control, applying, having the knowledge, having an understanding of the corruption of their own psychology. I suppose that's the first fact of being reasonable or rational, is recognition that my psychology isn't reliable. I mean, I can't say when exactly I realized that, you know, for the first time, but it certainly was in my very early youth. And certainly by the time you start falling in love and doing things like that, you're able to see how fickle and how superficial and how what low standards your psychology has for very, very high praise. How it's like the worst, it's worse than the most corrupt politician. How easily you will sell out your principles, you know, for those firm breasts, you know, that those big eyes, you know, that lovely symmetry, and that you sell out for this aesthetic nonsense. So yeah, 11 years old, for certain. But there's probably lots of examples I could give where I already knew my brain was unreliable, that it wasn't telling me the true value of things, that it would build me up full of expectations and I would be all horny for something. And when it really happened, I'd be, what the hell was that all about? You know, lots of opportunity to recognize how the feelings were playing me and I wasn't playing the feelings. And clearly I would argue I am not capable of playing the feelings in any kind of elaborate professional way. I wouldn't sell you know, my guide to touching yourself or whatever, or getting in touch with yourself as the guide. You know, because I'm probably doing it all wrong. But who cares? It's not relevant, in my opinion, to the more important fact of my existence, is that, what is, am I living honestly? Am I participating without lying to myself or others? That's the, you know, what's the effect of my existence? What's the intent of my existence? And that's the more important part to get right, in my opinion, especially once you know the game, as you've been denied intuitive or visceral knowledge. The game isn't your sensibilities. It isn't your mommy and daddy, your brother and sister. It isn't your kids. The game is other sentient beings that you will impact, especially those living in the future. You're making the world they'll live in. And that's a huge responsibility. It's a huge power you're exercising. And to say you didn't sign a contract accepting responsibility for that impact is still no excuse. Doesn't get you out of it. The fact is, you have the power. It's yours to exercise. And if you have knowledge of the road and you abdicate, that's a decision. That's a responsible choice. A choice you can you can be called defective, broken, stupid, fucktarded, for failing to add the 2 plus 2. And the 2 being, you have the power, plus the I have the knowledge. You have to do the 4. You have to do the I combine power and knowledge and say, yes, the power must be exercised through wisdom, not through personal interest, personal passion. You can't drive the bus while you're masturbating. Just one of those little rules, you know, that that's not how it's not going to be effective. Ayn Rand was an idiot. She was a moron. Selfishness fails. It will not make you productive. It will not make the world a better place. It's just much more complicated than thinking you are innately designed to function in the best interest of the world. Silly to think that would be the way it works out. It doesn't work out that way. And all of human history demonstrates that it doesn't work out that way. And, yeah. So, but that's what's being sold. So let's not pretend that these people were selling a personal philosophy or a personal method. They're advocating for a theory of existence to justify, in part, their own adoption of it. They want to get others to believe it, not because it's good for the world, but because it's good for their rationalizations. It becomes much easier for them to say, oh yeah, even though this doesn't sound right, it's right, as long as there's a chorus behind them saying, yeah, that sounds like the right song to sing. The song of selfish asshole. Yeah. And you couldn't be more out of the game. I've made that metaphor before, but this is basically what the human race has done. Is we're playing American football, and they're playing European football. You're playing the wrong game, and you just keep breaking the rules because you're playing the wrong game. And you're not scoring positives, you're scoring negatives, because you're running the wrong way in every way. Not only directionally, but also in how you're placing your feet and what you're squishing as you do it. Wet. Speaking of squish, very squishy. So anyway. Anyway, so till next time, and such, so forth and whatnot. Pool. Not quite a pool yet. A couple weeks, though, cover comes off. Back in business. Yeah. Anyway, till next time, and such. Ah, back. Yeah, it is a nice day. There's people. My park. How horrible. Anyway, horseshoe. My walking ground. Look at the dog, too. Yuck. Anyway, where was I? Psychology versus philosophy. Same old, same old. Endless conversation. Yeah, it looks like a pit bull, too. God, I wish people would grow up, get normal dogs, friendly, happy dogs, instead of evil, maniacal dogs. Especially women, barely control them. Well, yeah, barely control them. Got a bunch of little bratikins out here. So anyway, yeah, I'm not making a video, just complain. Yeah, so this is the vice of not taking life seriously, is, you know, the consequential problem no one wants to deal with. Keep ignoring the little thieves and monsters created by reckless decision-making, indulging psychological obsessions, and you know, not recognizing that reality doesn't need more yelling psychologies, you know, more people to feed. Find something to parasite and feed on it. So, yeah, that's just too clear a fact, right? You know, that, you know, it might all go quite well. Just like you might go to Las Vegas and win. You know, but we know that for every winner, there's this many number of losers. And it doesn't really matter what the numbers are. Just the realization that there's no losers if you don't bother playing this I gotta win game. You don't chase, nothing gets run over. It's just the truth. And the need for it is just psychology. It's not a fact that exists in the universe. It's not a fact that life needs to exist. It's not a fact that it improves the condition of the universe to have sentient organisms chasing bliss, comfort, you know, chasing something to ease their pain. I mean, it just isn't a fact. There, so we're done now, right? It's just psychology that can contrive that necessity through its addiction. It's like the heroin molecule in and of itself. It's just this stupid molecule. No value, no anything. Just a molecule. It's only in the human mind, you know, that it generates something. And for every smile it generates, it also generates a frown. You're not going to win generating frowns. Can't pay for them with any kind of positive currency. It's just wrong to use somebody else's somebody else's suffering. I don't know, there's gotta be a better word, but somebody else's degrade in state as a payment for your profit. It's just fundamentally wrong. Yeah. Anyway. So yeah, we've been down this road before. Philosophy versus psychology. And is there any philosophy? Is there any way to bend rational philosophy into some inhumbled license to be reckless and sloppy and to function, attempt to function beyond your competence to play God? Is there any reason to play God? Any necessity for you to play it? No. So anyway, there's probably a better way to say that. So that is always true with language, is that words can be better arranged, but better doesn't mean more musically, you know, that they rhyme. Better usually means more explicit, more direct, more impervious to misunderstanding. Yes, that should be the goal. And it seems a lot of these other people advocate for exactly the opposite. They wish language to say nothing, so they can just make it up. They can just pretend you said go when you said stop. Yeah, pretty much. Anyway, Lily is feeling... I'm feeling it. Everything does look a little ratty here, though. Gotta find my little hackers. I don't know where I can't find my snippers. I don't need them. Get rid of all this twiggery here. Not your problem, but it does irritate me that I don't put things away. Anyway, not your problem. No, not entirely. It's your problem now because I'm going to talk about it. But anyway, enough of that. Nurse Santino! Well, did you have adventures today? Huh? Did you? Yeah? What'd you do? Are you around? What else did you do? Huh? What else did you do? You cat? Okay, I guess you didn't do anything all that important. Anyway, do have little plants growing. Not terribly badly. Yeah, they're moving right along. Probably killed them, but there's still hope. A little sneeze there, huh, buddy? Anyway, well, I'm sorry. I should be done with this. So till the next time and such. And so forth and whatnot.